If you are here to talk about Benezia's death, you need not bother. She brought it upon herself.
Don't pretend it doesn't bother you. She was your mother.
She was. But she was not. I prefer to remember Benezia as she used to be, before she was corrupted by Sovereign's power.
The best of your mother lives on in you. Her determination, her intelligence, her strength.
That is kind of you to say. I appreciate your concern, but I am fine. Benezia chose her path, just as I have chosen mine. I am with you until the end, Shepard.
Maybe we could pick up where we left off. You were telling me about your interest in the Protheans.
Actually, I think I was talking about my interest in you, and making a fool of myself in the process. As I said, I am not used to dealing with people, especially humans. I did not really know much about your species when we first met, Shepard. I found it hard to take humanity seriously. Your kind always seemed so rushed and high-strung.
Well, we don't have the luxury of time, and the Sari can live for 1,000 years. We're lucky if we hit 150.
That is true. At first I thought that was a weakness of your species. After spending time with you and your crew, however, I think it may actually be an advantage. You humans are creatures of action. You pursue your goals with an almost indomitable determination. It is an admirable trait, but also an intimidating one.
You're scared of us?
Unfortunately, the rest of the galaxy sees humanity as something of a bully. You run over anyone in your path to get what you want. It is up to people like you to change their minds, Shepard.
I'm doing the best I can, Liara.
There is a reason the Council chose you to become a Spectre. They saw something special in you. The best of what humanity has to offer. I looked into your history. I know what you did during the Blitz. It was a remarkable display of courage and heroism.
You didn't need to go behind my back. I would have told you whatever you wanted to know.
I apologize, Commander. After our last conversation, I was afraid I would say something stupid again. I wanted to know more about you. To understand what made you into the man you are. There is something compelling about you, Shepard.
Are you sure you're interested in me? Or is it my visions of the Protheans?
I admit, your connection to the Protheans had something to do with my initial interest. But it has grown beyond that. You intrigue me, Shepard. But I was not sure if it was appropriate to act on my feelings. I thought there might already be a relationship between you and Chief Williams.
Williams and I are just friends, nothing more.
My mistake, then. I am not as adept at understanding human relationships as I thought. But what about us, Shepard? Is there a mutual attraction, or was I wrong about that, too?
No, you were right. There is something between us.
I knew it, and I knew you felt it too. But does this not seem rather strange? Why do I feel so close to you? We have only known each other a short time. We are from two different species. We have almost nothing in common. This makes no sense.
These things never make sense. They just happen, and we get swept up in the storm.
You make it sound so chaotic, so dangerous.
I'll keep you safe.
I am not looking for a protector. This is all a bit overwhelming. I am not used to this. You. I need some time.
Take all the time you need, Liara. I'll be here.
Thank you, Shepard. Let's just talk about something else for now.
Do you know why Benezia joined up with Saren?
Benezia was swept up in events beyond her control and lost herself. She fell under the spell of indoctrination and became part of the very thing she wanted to stop. But I will remember and honor how she lived, not how she died. My mother was strong, kind, and beautiful. And now she is gone.
Are you going to be okay?
You are kind to ask, Shepard. I do miss her, and I grieve for what happened to her. But I will not let my grief interfere with what we are trying to accomplish.
I should go.